Hey, what's up guys, it's Ben Bonk, and recently I entered the Game Makers Toolkit Game Jam 2021. If you don't know, the Game Makers Toolkit Game Jam is a game jam hosted by Mark Brown from the YouTube channel Game Makers Toolkit, and it's one of the biggest game jams out there. Contestants have 48 hours to make a game from scratch, which must follow a given theme, and for this game jam I would be teaming up with Zaylof from the YouTube channel Hive, and Gizmote, who would be our composer. So without further ado, let's get into it. The jam started on June 11th, and the theme that was announced was Join Together. I thought this was a decent theme, and Zaylof and Gizmote and I hopped into a call to start brainstorming ideas. There are a lot of things that you could do with this theme that we thought of. For example, joining two characters together to make a puzzle, or joining two genres together. But after a bit over an hour of brainstorming, we decided on the idea of a top-down shooter where once enemies die, they would turn into corpses which could be picked up or joined together by other enemies to upgrade them. The player could also suction up these dead bodies to prevent other enemies from doing that first, so all in all, it'd be a top-down shooter with a bit of strategy involved, like when to kill enemies and when to try to suction them. This sounded like a good idea, so I hopped into Acesprite to start making some art, as Zaylof would be taking the lead on programming this time around. I ended up searching on LostSpec for some color palettes, and eventually I found this green color palette which I slightly expanded on, which I liked best because green always has a way of coming back to me. Anyways, I started working on the player character for this game. Our plan was for the game to be kind of science slash lab based, so I tried to create a scientist main character. After a bit of work, I ended up with this guy, who I think looks pretty good. I then started working on some other essential art. I made a basic weapon and started to work on the tile set. This tile set was a massive pain and it went through so many different versions. I tried to give it a lab slash building kind of feel, and eventually I had this. But this was too dark, so I changed it. And now this was just slime keep. Yeah, it was pretty hard to get the colors of this tile set to look good with the floor color, so I was just kind of lost there and I took a bit of a break from the tile set. Instead, I worked on a bit of the enemy's art. I created three basic melee enemies which would upgrade upon absorbing another enemy's dead body, and I also created a projectile for the player's weapon. Also, just to quickly interrupt, I have a few announcements. I'm hosting a game jam from June 25th to the 28th, so check that out if you're interested. I now have a Twitter account and a second channel, so please consider checking those out if you're interested, links in the description. But now a lot of the main art was done, so I figured I'd get to animating the player. So that's what I did. I basically made some simple run and idle animations, and things were looking good. By this time I headed into Unity, and Zaylof had some basic mechanics done, but the enemy AI was a bit finicky, so I briefly fixed that up. As you can see, the player can move around and shoot. Also, once a player kills an enemy, the enemy will leave behind its body, which the player can collect by pressing E. Then a circle will appear above the player, and once the circle is full, the enemy body will disappear. But before I continue with the video, I'd like to thank the sponsor of this video, Core. Core is a free game creation platform that allows you to build, publish, and play games. If you're just starting out with game development, Core is a great choice and allows you to quickly create your own games, and is especially useful if you want to set up a 3D multiplayer game, and it's all backed behind the Unreal Engine. And the best part is, you don't even need to know how to code, so you can get started making games instantly with their thousands of free, high-quality music, sound, and art assets with no coding required. But if you'd like to go deeper, feel free to create your own game logic in Lua. You can build games completely from scratch or remix and reimagine content from other Core users. Core also handles all the hassle involved with multiplayer networking for you, and they recently raised $100 million in financing by various investors, including Epic Games. You can also make money off Core, and they've announced an industry-leading revenue share of 50% revenue share with its top creators. Finally, Core is currently hosting the Where's My Shirt Jam, which is a two-week game-making contest where contestants will have to create a game using the Core Games platform. And best of all, there are $3,000 worth of prizes. If you're interested in Core, check out the link in the description, and thanks again to Core for sponsoring this video. But after that, I figured I would get back to finally fixing the tile set. So after many more changes and reworks, I eventually settled on this. It's nothing amazing, but I think it works. I then moved on to importing the player animations, and I just created a blend tree, and shortly after, the player can move around. And I also added in the weapon and projectile artwork. Next up, I worked on setting up some of the melee enemy animations. I started creating another enemy. This enemy would shoot out projectiles, and I kind of made him look like a slime, and yeah, we're still basically remaking Slime Keep at this point. But anyways, I then worked on creating some more basic environment art, which really didn't end up getting used much, but yeah, it's still there. By now, I was kind of waiting on Zaylof to finish a few of the dead body mechanics, and I was really tired of making art, so I figured I'd work on some basic quality of life additions. I worked on a bunch of essential things, like scene transitions, a pause menu, and an audio manager. Eventually, I ended up with this. There's now this pretty smooth scene transition. Also, enemies can now go off on their own and collect other dead enemies if they're closer to that dead enemy than the player, but the actual upgrading system for the enemies didn't work yet. Oh, and I also improved the gun's rotation and added a really basic pause menu. After this, Zaylop and I concluded that the game could use one more enemy, so we decided that a giant or tank enemy would work best. So I got to working on this giant enemy and making animations for him. This definitely isn't my best work, but whatever, I think it works. I then just worked on a really basic start screen which you can mute the game audio from and start the game. And I also added a ton of animations for all the enemies in the game. Alright, now we're on the last day of the jam and there is still so much to do. We still needed levels, polish, audio, and so much more. So I woke up early and instantly started grinding. The game needed a lot of game flow management, so I first worked on a death state for the player. With that done, I spent a ridiculous amount of time trying to fix many of the bugs that popped up and just tweaking and setting up small things. I also just ended up naming the game The Collector because, well, you collect stuff to win. Zaylop also created an ammo system where the player would have a limited amount of bullets and had to think strategically when to shoot. And upon collecting a dead body, the player would gain some ammo back. This changed the game massively, but I still think it's a good addition and it definitely added a lot more strategy to the game. I then created a win mechanic where the player must collect all the enemy bodies in a room to move on to the next level. With all that done, there's still a few issues that I was waiting on for Zaylop to fix, but the game had all the core mechanics done, so I got to creating levels. I honestly didn't put too much thought and time into these levels as there's only a few hours left in the jam, and there's still so much other stuff to do. But eventually I finished about 9 basic levels, which were pretty much just made up of me randomly placing enemies and terrain across empty rooms. Now it's time for some other essential things. For example, I set up a ton of sound effects that Gizmote found, and also imported the soundtrack that Gizmote made for the jam, which I'll play briefly now. Huge shout out to Gizmote, I really like this soundtrack, and I thought it fit the game really well. Anyways, now the core game was pretty much done, but there's still very little polish and absolutely no playtesting. So I tried to make a build for playtesting about an hour before the jam ended, but of course there were bugs that completely broke the game from progression, and you can imagine how the panic started to set in. So in that last hour, Zaylop and I were in just pure grind slash panic mode. I eventually added a basic tutorial and a few small bits of polish like a muzzle flash and a bullet destroy effect, and Zaylop added some basic post-processing. But most of our time was spent just trying to fix bugs and issues with the game. Now, time was pretty much out, but thankfully the jam was extended 20 minutes because of issues with itch.io and their servers being super overloaded, which kind of saved us and allowed us to iron out most of the game-breaking issues with our game. Finally, we built, I made some cover art for the itch page, and the game was finally done. Overall, I'm decently happy with our game and the feedback has been pretty positive. The one major complaint we've been getting though is that the game is too hard, which is kind of true, and that is a direct result of not spending enough time testing levels, which is something I really wish we had more time for. But I still think every level is completely doable as long as you think about your strategy going into it for long enough. I also kind of wish we could have used the theme a bit better in the long run and made the joining together mechanic more central, as it kind of escaped from us as time passed, but it is what it is. Well, if you want to play the game, check out the link in the description. Also, huge shout out to Core for sponsoring this video, and for Zaylop and Gizmote for teaming up with me for this jam. Make sure to check them out in the description, they both make great work. Also, don't forget about the Ben Bonk Game Jam and my second channel, and if you consider checking that out, that would be awesome. And if you like this video, consider leaving a like or subscribing. Anyways, I'll see you guys in the next video,